We at Monmouth Medical Center Southern Campus are very excited and privileged to actually introduce a cutting-edge revolutionary technology. It is called FFR-CT, Fractional Flow Reserve, CT, which is computed tomography. It uses artificial intelligence to calculate the flow across the blockages or blockage that we see in the arteries supplying the blood to the heart. If the compromise of the flow is significant, then we need to do something about that blockage by ways of putting in a stent or sending them for bypass surgery. If the FFR is not significant, then we can safely treat those patients with medicines, with aspirin, with statins, with beta blockers and other medications which are heart protective.
When Dr. Mohan had asked for a volunteer patient, I without a doubt, I said, let's see what's going on with me, and I volunteered.
The test is pretty much straightforward. If people have gone for a regular CAT scan, it is something like that. It's not very cumbersome. It's not very tedious. You don't have to prepare for it.
Lo and behold, I was really surprised that they found something in my heart. They found that 99% of my right coronary artery is blocked.
According to them, my three arteries were blocked. Not one, not two, but three.
Here I am thinking that I'm so healthy and doing the exercises that my doctor had recommended, you know, doing a lot of biking. I just couldn't believe that this is happening to me.
Obviously, you know, you always feel like maybe this test is wrong because I don't feel like I have all these things. And being a doctor, I know it is real, but I'm saying to myself, maybe it is wrong. So we jumped to the next step, which is cardiac catheterizing, and it was right. I mean, I got six cardiac stents.
The test needs to be done appropriately. There are appropriateness criteria by the American College of Cardiology for the cardiac CT, as well as for the FFR-CT. Patients need to have symptoms, chest pain, whether it is typical, atypical, shortness of breath and exertion, which a lot of people actually disregard, in association with some of the coronary risk factors. Risk factors like smoking, risk factors like hypertension, diabetes, high cholesterol, family history. If patients have those risk factors and symptoms, then I think they're ideal candidates for this study. Almost 3 out of 4 patients who undergo an invasive diagnostic cardiac catheterization do not have any significant blockage or blockages. What this test does is it can potentially replace those unnecessary invasive procedures.
With 99% blockage, I could have suffered a heart attack at any given moment. So I really owe my life to this technology and to Dr. Mohan.